Denmark's third largest city. A natural center for knowledge and innovation. Frontier for robotic technologies, drone technologies, and health technologies. Hans Christian Andersen's birthtown. A vibrant city, hosting major events and festivals. Odense. Connect, collaborate, create. Odense. Denmark's third largest city. A natural center for knowledge and innovation. Frontier for robotic technologies, drone technologies, and health technologies. Hans Christian Andersen's birthtown. A vibrant city, hosting major events and festivals. Odense. Connect, collaborate, create. Odense. Denmark's third largest city. A natural center for knowledge and innovation. Frontier for robotic technologies, drone technologies, and health technologies. Hans Christian Andersen's birthtown. A vibrant city, hosting major events and festivals. Odense. Connect, collaborate, create. Odense. Denmark's third largest city. A natural center for knowledge and innovation. Frontier for robotic technologies, drone technologies, and health technologies. Hans Christian Andersen's birthtown. A vibrant city, hosting major events and festivals. Odense. Connect, collaborate, create.
So welcome back to viewers for the live stream here. We've got Court 2 coverage live, quarterfinals here at the Denmark Open 2017. Men's singles quarterfinal up next. And the number one seed, world number two currently, Son Wan Ho of Korea. And he's facing H.S. Prannoy of India, the man who dispatched Lee Chong Wei yesterday in the last 16. Prannoy currently ranked 14 in the world, unseeded here at the Denmark Open. And a man capable of some really fierce attack when he chooses to do so. Son Wan Ho, Mr. Consistent, such a controlled and solid mover around the court. Very much like his teammate Lee Hyun Il, who we saw earlier on this very court come through his quarterfinal against Raj Youssef of England in a very comfortable looking second game. And it's Lee Hyun Il waiting for the winner of this match in tomorrow's semi-finals. Well, these two have met three occasions before today. And in a 21-9 third game, it was Prannoy who won their last meeting. That was back in February at the Robot Badminton Asia Mixed Team Championships. Those drops from the rear court from Prannoy a little too slow for my liking, giving Son Wan Ho too much time at the net. Prannoy back on good form again this year. He's not that far from his career high at 12 in the world. That was 2 years ago, around the same sort of time. 25 years of age now, Prannoy. And picks up his only win so far in 2017 at the US Open. I was there commentating. It was an all-Indian final, as I recall. Pretty sure he was up against his teammate Kashyap Parupalli on that day. Indonesian Open semi-finalist also. Prannoy, another good performance for him that week. Tricky matches Prannoy's had to come through this week already. Not only that round 16 match yesterday against Lee Chong Wei, but a tough match against Emil Holst of Denmark in the first round, 18 and 19 that win. Already done one better than he did this time last year at the Denmark Open, again round 16 against Lee Chong Wei. Chong Wei won in straight games last year. He was the number one seed. Lovely control from Son Wan Ho.
Four.
often looks like a training rally at times, Son Wan-ho, the way he moves around the court, keeping the shuttle in play. Prannoy missed the kill. Son Wan-ho able to get a racket to it, but only to put it into the net. Oh, fantastic. Backhand defense technique from Prannoy. Not able to keep it in court. Well, that cross smash miles away. Another one just wide from Prannoy. He'll be disappointed at the errors. To this point, the main reason for the gap in scoreline. Another one called out, which looks to have landed very close to that line indeed. Prannoy instantly looking for a challenge, but court two here at Denmark Open, no challenge system in place. Another miss from Prannoy gives Son Wan-ho the 6-point lead at the mid-game interval, 11-5, and Prannoy just needs to keep the shuttle in court.
Here. Judge.
For 2:20 seconds.
Another error, Prannoy. And he's making life very easy for Song Wan Ho at the moment. Another one. That sideline really isn't liking HS Prannoy today. Footwork from Song Wan Ho in defence. Did all the hard work, unable to control the lift. Too short, too low, too easy for Song Wan Ho. Wow, what a smash, left leg jump out round the head. Again, Prannoy trying something special and failing, making it too easy once more.
Thank you.
That's a better lift from Prannoy. Nice and flat into that rear corner. Well, Prannoy at the moment doesn't seem to have the game plan to beat this man. Trying too hard with the lines at times and trying too much with deception as well. A terrible opening game for Prannoy, far too many errors and weak shots, and Son Wan Ho cruising through, taking the opening game 21-13. Number two in the rankings currently, Son Wan Ho. He was number one, of course, Victor Axelsen of Denmark, after winning the World Championships in August, overtook Son Wan Ho, 12,000 ranking points for winning the World Champs. Axelsen also with that Super Series finals win for another 11,000 points back in December. And a ton of other decent results puts Axels on top of the rankings, but Son Wan Ho not far behind. So consistent. He won the Korean Masters back in December.
Second game. Level.
And then a string of semi-finals, the Malaysian Open, Indonesian Open, the World Championships, of course, Korean Open, Japan Open, all making the last four and picking up another 6,000 or so ranking points every time. Oh, in so quick. Reverse light into court. The defensive block from Prannoy was weak. Oh, what a rally. And it's in for once, Prannoy. The spinning net shot. Son Wan Ho with the kill. Somehow Prannoy got a racket to the shuttle and kept the rally alive. Thank you. Well, a better start to this game, HS Prannoy. Managing to stay with Song Wan Ho for the moment. What a block from Song Wan Ho, the cross smash came down like a rocket.
Thank you.
Well, some great shot making in this match so far, but also quite a few errors from both players. On Wan Ho, miss with the cross smash.
And our court number one men's singles.
Well,
from India, the winner of Indonesia Open and currently ranked 8th in the world. Ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together and welcome Chidambi Srikant.
Well, a big crowd in here, the atmosphere is going to be pumped up a few notches in a moment. Chidambi Srikant of India has just made his way to the court, but everybody's waiting for Victor Axelsen.
Ladies and gentlemen, let's make some noise for our local hero, Victor Axelsen!
Plenty of support for Victor as he makes his way out onto court number one, but we've got a tense enough second game here between Song Wan Ho, the number one seed, and Prannoy of India. And Prannoy off to a much better start to the second game. 3 points to lead at the interval. Much closer second game. on Wan Ho, 1 point behind Prannoy. Yeah, good kill at the net, tight spinning net shots. Oh, diving defense from Prannoy. Well, 13 all here. Prannoy much more in control until the commentator's curse. But much more in control of his shot making in this second end. Kill up the net from Prannoy, good backhand technique.
Chou!
deception from Son Wan Ho, keeping Prannoy on the run. And a good leave from Prannoy. Well, that one looked to be in. Line judge called it out. Cheap points for Prannoy, 16 all here in the second. Out at the last moment, Prannoy, great leave. 2 points in front. Forehand push, error, Prannoy. Son Wan Ho draws back to level, turns 18 all. Slice from Son Wan Ho to get himself out of trouble. But Prannoy's thrown away that lead. Well, Son Wan Ho gets himself back in front somehow. Looking for a change of shuttle. Opponent says no, umpire agrees. And it's match point, Son Wan Ho. Oh, great defence from the Korean. And it's gone wide, Prannoy. Heartbreaking for him. He was almost there to take us to a third game. Son Wan Ho in straight games. through to another Denmark Open semi-final in 44 minutes. The number one seed is through 21-13, 21-18. So don't go away, we've got women's doubles quarterfinal action next for you. Here on court number two, Huang, Yaqiong and Yu Xiaohan of China up against the Koreans Lee So-hee and Shin Seung Chan.
Level. Play.
Well, a pretty even start here for all in the opening game, women's doubles quarter final. Both pairs looking to make Super Series events there, home. So many combination changes within women's doubles from China and Korea in the last 12 months. Both of these pairs way down the rankings. The Chinese at 59, the Koreans at 112, but largely due to the amount of matches and tournaments they've played together. Huang Yaqiong and Yu Xiaohan, only their fifth tournament as a pair. To the disgust of their opponents, I'm sure they won the Korean Open early last month. However, it's the Korean pair that lead the head-to-head between the two. They've met twice before. The Koreans took both of those. Chinese pair individually have reached number 10 and number 12 in the world rankings, just to show a sign of their true quality, really. That their current ranking of 59 doesn't really do them justice. So he and Shin Seung Chan just their third tournament together. Nevertheless, Lee So he still ranked up at number 3 in the world rankings with her former partner. These two fresh from a win in LA a couple months back, the US Open Grand Prix Gold event. Shin Seung Chan currently ranks number 5 on her own. Late last year she was up at number 2 in the world with her former partner. So on paper the rankings look a little strange, but it's the Koreans you could argue would be favourites to take this match, despite currently together being 159th in the world. In truth, they are one of the best women's doubles players around this year. One more time, we've seen Yu Xiaohan trying to cut out in the midcourt. Anticipated well, but didn't quite judge the height of the lift. Good cross lift from Huang Yaqiong. Great rally, great defending from both pairs. Lee So-hee with the error, forehand into the net. Oh, brilliant stuff from Huang Yaqiong, controlling the rally. Well constructed attack. Oh, well left. The Chinese right back in this. Oh.
please call the technical officials to court number three.
Oh, that's brilliant from Shin. Saw the big space as Huang Yaqiong backed off. Good disguise on the net shot. Yeah, good play from the Koreans again, using the open spaces.
70, 50.
Well, it's like cat and mouse here at the moment with this women's doubles. Not a great deal to choose between them. Koreans perhaps preferring to get Shin Seung Chan at the back of the court to use her power. In which case they'd like to see Lee So-hee forced to the back more often to get them out of their preferred formation. Perhaps a tactic the Chinese will be looking to adopt. Was Yu Xiaohan doing? Huang blocked a net and followed it in. Her partner had no right to be stood in front of her. She forgot how to rotate for a moment. Great defense, Shin Seung Chan. Oh, it's great defense again from this, from the Chinese this time. What a rally. Huang gambling and putting her partner in trouble. Worth a gamble perhaps, but it didn't pay off. The Koreans too smart for that, and it's Lee and Shin with game point. Defense from Yu Xiaohan. Better this time from the Chinese. Oh, but Huang wasn't able to get the push past Lee Sohee. Pounced on the loose net and first game all over in favor of the Koreans. Lee Sohee, Shin Seung Chan ahead 21-17. Oh, game two about to get underway. The Koreans in front, taking the first. A lot of the noise you can hear in here. Currently, just so you know, for court one, Victor Axelsen. One game up and 19 all, but Srikanth has just gone in front 20-19. 1 point might take that match to a third game decider. Massive applause for the Koreans going to love ahead. No, I'm kidding. Axelsen on court one has just drawn level 20 all in the second.
Three, love.
Ah, tremendous net shot from Lee Sohee with the help of the net court. Any men's singles fans listening in, Vix Axelsen, world champion, has just gone to a third game with India's number one, Kidambi Srikanth. Service judge, Seamus from Ireland, just calls racket head pointing in a upward direction. Great smash from Shin Seung Chan. Perfect placement into the body of Chou Xiaohan. Looking more comfortable in game 2, 7-2 in front. Good recovery from Shin. But Lee Soo-hee unable to keep the push in court. Rotation from the Koreans. Smashing cross allows your partner to come out and take the rear court. Very well worked attack from Shin and Lee. Thank you. Yeah, looking pretty strong right now. Shin and Lee of Korea, 11-4 mid-game interval. Lay off to the midcourt. Lee So Hee. Good defending from the Chinese. Pick up from you. In the end, the attack was too strong. Relentless from the Koreans. So he, well, any men's singles fans that are not able for any reason to watch court one, just a little update for you. World champion and local hero Victor Axelsen struggling out there in the quarterfinals against Kidambi Srikanth of India. They've gone to three. Srikanth currently in the lead, 11-4 on that court. Decision from the Chinese. That's one of their downfalls. We've seen that all match so far. Now and again, one of them makes the wrong move and they get in each other's way. Well, 10 points, and it looks as though the writing might be on the wall here in this women's doubles quarter final. One game down, the Chinese 10 points behind in the second. Well, it looks like we're in for an upset here in Uwanza. Axelson 16-4 down in the third against Kadambi Srikanth. And it appears Axelson's game is falling apart. Oh, look at the net cord. Don't need the luck, but they'll take it anyway. The Koreans still with that 10-point advantage. And that 17-7 closing in on tomorrow's semi-finals. Yeah, too much power. Once more, the Koreans. Eight now, and news is Axelson on the brink of going out of his home tournament. Well, he's picked up 1 point, but he's 27 down in the third, and it's just a matter of time before Victor Axelson, world champion, goes out of the Denmark Open. Shin Seung Chan with the serve, 19-8. Oh, and the error of Li Sohee's slower drop shot. It's all falling apart for the Chinese. Yu Xiaohan and Huang Yaqiong. Shin serving at match point. And they'll have another chance, the Chinese. The applause you can hear are for Kadambi Srikanth, and a farewell to Victor Axelson, who's just lost and is out of the tournament. Looking great in the opening game. Very close second game, but something of a disaster in the third. 21-7, he was defeated by Kadambi Srikanth. Another point saved by the Chinese. 10 points still the difference. 10 match points to the Koreans. They don't need any more. And they are through. Women's doubles in 41 minutes. One of the shorter women's doubles we are likely to see over the next few days. Shin Seung Chan, Lee So Hee. Dominant in the second game are through to the semi-finals in straight games, 21-17, 21-10. Well, next game up, final game up on court two, men's singles, the number five seed from Taipei back in action, Chou Tien Chen. And he's up against Vincent Wong, Wong Wing Ki of Hong Kong. And that's coming up next for you.
Please welcome the technical officials to court number one.
Thank you.
So we've got the last quarterfinal for the day live on court number two now coming up. It's the men's singles. It's Chou Tien Chen of Chinese Taipei, the number five seed, the ranked number five player in the world right now. He's up against a man he's played many times. This will be the ninth meeting between him and his opponent here, Wong Wing Kee. Unseeded this tournament, ranked 15th. Chou Tien Chen, dressed pretty in pink. Number five seed, ranked number five, as I mentioned. Now 27 years of age, from the city of Taipei in Taiwan. Another familiar name in the latter stages of Super Series events. Not only that, quarter finalist at the World Championships a couple months back. Unbelievably, the head-to-head between these two stands at 5-3 in favour of Chou Tien Chen, who has won all five of the last five meetings. Wong Wing Kee has not beaten this man since February 2013, albeit all five of those last five meetings have gone down to a third game decider.
Four, three.
and it's been pretty close every single time looking at this track record here. So we might be in for a long one. Key, or Vincent Wong as he's known, former top 10 player himself, not long ago. He's not that far from his best, that was only a few months back. Same age as Xiaohan Chen, just 2 months apart in age. Have the same track record of results over the last 12 months. Round one, round two defeats in places. Semi-final at Malaysia Open perhaps his best result, although quarter-finalist in the World Championships. Slightly different circumstances, of course. World Championships, where only two players from any one country able to participate. Countries such as China, India, Denmark even, who have a number of players in the top 20. Possibly making for a slightly easier opening round at such a major event. Winning the event, of course, an entirely different matter. Cross net.
Service over. Eight,
nine. Eight.
4-2, 20 seconds.
Well, 2 points the difference. Chou Tien Chen leading at the break. A couple of unforced errors from Vincent Wong early on in the match has cost him really, and I don't really think that's going to be too crucial at this stage. A long way to go yet between these two, so used to hour-long close battles. Well, great pickup from Wong, but Chou Tien Chen in so early.
Service over. 14-11. Service over. 12-14.
Better from Chou Tien Chen. As always, looking so composed in attack. Another great mover around the court. We were talking earlier about Son Wan Ho and Lee Hyun Il. This is another guy that really does look smooth when he's moving around a singles court. Great reverse slice from Wong Wing Ki, but good defence again. Well, holding up momentarily, Chou Tien Chen. Still unable to make a difference to that 2 point lead though, Vincent Wong. Oh, incredible cross block. Well, the net shot from Chou was good, but what impressive reply from Vincent Wong. Well, getting out of trouble once more, Vincent Wong, deep in the forehand rear corner. Generates great power from a late position, whipping it back cross court, and Chou Tien Chen, unexpected.
From India, the service judge, Commander Khan from England.
As expected, these two, nothing between them, 16 all. The drop shot that did the damage, pulling Xiaohan Chen far out wide. Weak lift and punished by Vincent Wong. He's ahead for the first time in the game. Oh, it's brilliant from Vincent Wong. Again, Vincent Wong just showing that he's not prepared to give away the attack.
Service over.
Forcing Xiaohan Chen to lift. Another net cord. Return of serve from Chou, but this time Wong able to stay on top of things. An unbelievable turnaround in game one. Xiaohan Chen now falling behind, and Vincent Wong with three game points. Yeah, very good attacking. Xiaohan Chen waiting for Vincent to move. Backhand kill into the body. Still 2 points behind, serving game point down. Good net play again from Vincent Wong. And it's gone long. Xiaohan Chen staying patient. Oh, it's going wide, surely. Taking no chances, Xiaohan Chen, and a cross-court smash around the head corner. He's clawed things back, saved three game points. Well, these two at the moment might as well toss a coin for who takes this game. Massive upset just moments ago, of course, this half of the draw in the men's singles. Victor Axelsen, the number 2 seed, the world champion, knocked out in 3 games by Kidambi Srikanth. Axelsen was just terrible in the third. His game really did fall apart. 21-8, I think the final score. And Kidambi Srikanth waiting in the semi-finals for the winner of this match. The other semi-final in the men's singles, Korean teammates, and a repeat of last year's semi-final, Son Wan Ho versus Lee Hyun Il of Korea. 21-20. Well, it's game point number 4 for Vincent Wong. Great net play from both once more. Brilliant from Chou Tien Chen. But he's given the point to the man from Hong Kong. Umpire says his racket was over the net. Chou Tien Chen stares in disbelief. He can't believe he's just given away that opening game after a tremendous net game on game point. Cross net after 3 net shots in a row was incredible from Chou Tien Chen, and he almost looked lethargic in the kill. It was so easy for him, but the umpire says his racket head struck the shuttle on his opponent's side of the court, and it's Wong Wing Ki who takes the opening game 22-20. Oh, a bit of deception, Chou Tien Chen on the backhand. Double action lift. Vincent Wong managing to keep things going.
One, four, 10, 9,
Yeah, good judgment, Xiao Tien Chen, letting that one drift out into the tram lines. Well, the reverse slice cross court from Wong out. And again, a cagey start to the game. Oh, great attacking Xiao Tien Chen, but what defense in return. Nothing to choose between these two. A little luck or indecision, perhaps. That's the only difference. Cross-court smash from Wong into the tape. So 5-3, game two with Vincent Wong, one game up.
Service over, 4-5.
Net shot this time, Xiao Tien Chen. It's like fire and ice, these two. Nothing between them in the rallies. Yeah, good judgment, Xiaotian Chen.
Service over. 8-7.
Oh, well, Xiaotian Chen leapt for the kill. Wong Winky just able to defend it and push it back past the man from Taipei. Oh, what a shot, Xiaotian Chen. Vincent Wong, nod of approval. He lifted cross court, Xiaotian Chen. Around the head, back cross court. Incredible. Well, it's a very narrow difference still in the scoreline. Xiaotian Chen, 11-10, second game. Thank you.
14-11.
Chou Tien Chen struggling. 4 points in a row to Vincent Wong. Body defense off the hip from Chou Tien Chen. Oh. Oh, two in a row off the tape. No matter how tough the going gets, Chou Tien Chen always looks so relaxed. In the lead by 3 points after winning four in a row, but Chou Tien Chen replies with four in a row of his own. Good backhand cross block and the lift out wide. Kill this time, no complaint from the umpire. He really went for it. Looking impatient for the first time, Chou Tien Chen. Really hunting that cross smash. He missed by miles. Small cushion of 2 points, the lead. Thank you. Tremendous straight smash. Chou Tien Chen, 3 points the lead, 19-16. It seems history might be repeating itself, if it's not too early to say. But these two always go to three games. Let's see if the commentator can put a curse on this one as well. Well, Vincent Wong picking his moments. 20-17 behind after winning the first. He would very much like another run of 4 points in a row. High lifts, taking no chances. Vincent Wong, and the cross smash followed up with the forehand kill. There's 1 point back at least. Gone long as well. 19, there's 20. Two. One more point needed. Vincent Wong to take us to setting. Body smash. Found the right hip. And he's done it. Tien Chen composing himself. Needed that point. Chou Tien Chen desperately needed that point. To take us to a third game. It's Chou Tien Chen who has to lift. Body smash again, working for Vincent Wong. Thank you. Well, it worked last time for Vincent Wong. He was 3 points down at game point. He asked for the court to be mopped and a chance to towel down. 21 all, and there's something going on with the courts. It doesn't appear to be sweat, as the guy with the mop has not been called, but the one of the referees has been called instead, who's slowly moving across the court to take a look at what's going on. Well, with a towel the size of a postage stamp, I think there might have been a little blood on the court. Sorted out very quickly, and now the court moppers are out as well. Well, medical attention to Vincent Wong's finger. More and more likely that on one of those diving defensive shots, grazed a finger, started to bleed. We saw a very similar thing last night on court two late on. HK Vittinghus needed all five of his digits on his racket hand repairing. Blood mopped from the court, and finally Vincent Wong back on court. Just to build the tension, no doubt. Change of shuttles, mop of the court, fix the blood, take your finger. Still game level at 21 all. Crucial moment. Well, that cry tells you how much it means to Chou Tien Chen. Court punch clear forehand, Vincent Wong, and great attack. Well, again, much like game one, flip a coin. Minutes played, 22 all in the second. Rally. Ends in a error, defensive block, straight net for Chou Tien Chen. And after 51 minutes, first match point, and the momentum is with Vincent Wong right now. And it's all over. Wong Wing Ki Vincent. He's been beaten by Xiaotian Chen the last five times they've met. Good sportsmanship between the two players. Xiaotian Chen disappointed, but a great performance from Vincent Wong. He's even playing to the crowd after that win. Well, interesting to see what happened at the end of that game, the last five or six points. Professionalism and just huge experience called upon. Vincent Wong, three game points down. Chose then to request a break to towel down in the courts to be mopped. He won the next 3 points, drew them level. A few minutes later, crunch time again, and he picked that moment to slow the play down, repair a finger, mop the floor, take a break, recompose himself, and it worked once more. Clever stuff. Anyway, we're through today's quarterfinals. Vincent Wong will be meeting Kidambi Srikanth tomorrow in the semis. That's it from us here for another day at the Denmark Open. I'm Bobby Griffin saying thank you for tuning in, and we hope to have you all tune in again tomorrow for semi-finals day. Good night from everybody here.
You were up against a very talented opponent. Why did he win today?
其实非常有天赋的选手，为什么他今天赢了？你觉得？
每天大家状况不一样嘛，那可能他今天状况特别好吧，所以谁都有可能赢嘛。Yes,
like every day. Maybe we are in different conditions for each player. Maybe today he's in a better condition than me, so that's why he won this game.
If you could turn back time, what would you do differently?
有什么可以改进的地方吗？再来一遍的话。
今天速度比较慢，那可能他准备的比较充分吧。我可能之后包括开局，还有后面。
For me, maybe my speed is not fast enough, and for him, and he reacts more quickly, and maybe I need to concentrate at the first beginning and at the latter part also. Yeah.
What do you think about your overall performance in this tournament?
整体的表现怎么样？
我觉得还可以吧，就是。 有把自己水平打出来，但是可能结果不如预期吧。不过还可以接受这样。Maybe
the result is not very satisfied, but actually I think my overall performance is fine, and it's a result that I can accept it, so it's still okay for me.
Thank you very much.